Welcome back to this playthrough for Bioshock Infinite. And now we're going back to what I guess is chapter 31. Like I said, very confusing this whole chapter situation here. I think even one of the Vox phones I got doesn't even count for chapter 31 as far as the guides I'm following talk about. So what is this? Cunningham Studios. Weird. Alright, so there's that Vox phone I had.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection. I don't know.
I saw a flash over here, but it must just be a reflection. Just real quick, just to make sure it counts. Alright, so now what I'm going to do is run back to the Lutece house. I'm not sure which way is the fastest. So I'll just meet y'all over there. Alright, here we are, we're back at the market district. This is where the second tier is located. But before I go in there, there's that door into the Lutece whatever, but then there's this one over here that I didn't unlock either.
Fancy putting those lock picking skills to work?
Keep a lookout. It's done.
Search a box of chocolates. Okay. How would you put a can of beans in a box of chocolate? None of this makes any sense. Maybe I'd like some caramels in my box of caramels. What's up with you weirdos? Keep what I got on. If I have to resort to melee, I want to be able to get healed from it. Can you imagine the disappointment getting a box of chocolates and there being beans in there? I mean, I like beans too, but not when I'm going for chocolate. That was kind of disappointing for three lockpicks.
Can you open this?
This won't take long at all. Ready.
Pretoria Lutece. There should be quite a bit of Vox bones and stuff in here. This lockpick, very good. I guess we'll do the downstairs first. Must be the chair right there. Oh, there's a box phone.
Comstock seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist.
Okay. almost looked like it was flashing over there for a second. Before I open up the tear, I'm gonna go upstairs. Bit of an enormous power drain up here in this place. There's a fusion over there.
Feel better already.
Oh, well, that's the thing from downstairs. They have it going through the floor. How about that? Yeah, nothing else up here. Okay, so let's open that tear. Messed up.
I don't think that's the real Lady Comstock. I think she's a combination of herself and my feelings towards her.
What do you mean?
I'm just so angry at her and at my father. I think she's her, but she's also partly me. I'm not even sure I understand it myself.
Lady Comstock seems to believe the child is a result of some errant act of carnality between myself and her beloved prophet. I told the poor woman the truth, that the child was a product of our little contraption, but I think she found that less believable than her delusion.
So, I think that's been 3 Vox phones so far in this chapter. I think the most we're going to find is probably going to be here in the last area, the bank. So if I'm mistaken, this should be the bank. Yep. I'm kind of in trouble right now. Give me a second.
That's it.
Alright. I need more skyline hook strikes anyway. Probably this. remotely. That one counts. Those crow guys, I'm gonna have to try and burn them. Salts, not really. Something else. somebody.
In the name of the prophet!
Oh, there you are. See these before.
You hold on to this. Here you go.
Oh, there's a gun automaton. I have a gun. I wasn't expecting that tough of a fight when I came through here. Guess that was naive of me. I remember coming in here earlier. Well, actually, I didn't do that. I don't think that door was open last time I came in here. Go in. Okay.